Hello friends, hope you all are doing great. I'm sorry for not uploading sessions since few days. There were some unavoidable circumstances to deal with. Let's proceed further. Today I will explain commit and rollback commands in SQL. I would request you to please watch this video till end because these basic concepts are the first one to be asked in interviews. Commit is equivalent to save and rollback is equivalent to undo. Save and undo are very familiar words whenever you work on any file or Excel or Word, you make sure to save your changes so that whenever you will open it again or whoever will open will get the updated information. Otherwise, if you don't want to continue with the changes, you will undo the changes done and then you will save so that you will get whatever you want to proceed with. This is the same case with commit and rollback. These two operations, these two commands are used to save the database changes or to undo the database changes. Okay? Let us understand these with the help of one simple pictorial diagram. I have a database table called person with three columns, ID, name and age. I want to throw an update command over this table. I want to update the name as BBB for ID 3. So I have written the query update person, person is table name, set name equal to whatever I want, where id equal to 3. We have already seen this update commands and all. Those who have missed this session can proceed by subscribing this channel. Now let's proceed. I am applying this update command on this table. I have two options. Either I want to save it or I want to undo the changes made after this update command. Let us see what happens if I commit the changes. If I commit the change, my data in the third row will be updated as BBB in name column because I have updated that particular value in my table. This is how we can say commit command is used to save all the transactions to the database till last commit or rollback. This is the definition and the prerequisite. When do you want to go for commit? When you need to go for commit is we need to explicitly commit the insert, update and delete transactions. Whenever you will be using insert command, update command or you will be deleting any data from your table, you should follow a habit of either committing it or if you want to proceed with the save, otherwise rollbacking it. This is the commit concept. Now, I don't want to commit this change. I want to keep the name of ID3 as PQR itself. So instead of commit, now I'll throw a command rollback. Rollback will not change my name for ID3. It will keep the table intact as it is, as it was till last commit. So rollback definition says rollback command is used to undo all the transactions to the database till last commit or rollback. I hope theoretically it is clear, but let us see how we can differentiate the situations where we have committed and not committed or rollbacked. Let us proceed with the database. I have a table. Same scenario we'll see. Select star from person. I have three rows and three columns. Columns ID, name and age. Now I want to update update, which table? Person table. Set, which column to set? Name. Value to set is BBB. Condition, where id is 3. This command, if I run, now assume this task window of SQL is nothing but a normal Word file. Whenever you update the Word file, any change you do, you can see the change. But if someone else is also referring to the same file, he won't be able to see the change until you save it. Okay, let us make it more clear. Now one row updated. As I'm working in this session, if now without, I have not committed it till now. If I now select star from person, it will show me as if the changes are done. But this is because I'm working in this session. If I have two sessions, one in which we have updated, other one not updated. Other one we have not worked in that session till now. So suppose second user came and he wants to refer the person table. If he will run this command in his other session, he will see the exact data which is saved. It means even though this BBB here is visible after update command ran, it won't be saved until we throw a commit command. Now if I commit here, run it, commit complete here in this session, obviously 3BBB, and what happens to my fresh session now? It will also show me. Yes, this is how we need to commit so that every person or user referring to that particular table gets the most updated information. We need to follow this rule for insert, update and delete. We have seen with the update. Now let's see rollback with the help of insert. I want to insert into person table values, let's say 4. This is name and this is age. We'll keep this 5, 6. We will see while inserting these 3 records how we can roll back and commit based on the requirements. I want to insert one new record. Insert this one row, inserted. I've selected one row, one insert command, and I've ran this one row is inserted. Even though it is inserted, it is not yet saved. Select star from person. Is in the same session we have inserted, so it will show me the 4th row. But in my fresh session, it will show me only 3 rows because we have not committed the change. Suddenly I came to know that this person is no more. So I don't need this record. What should I do? Either I should commit and then delete, or I can roll back this action because I have not committed it till now. Roll back. I want to undo this action. I'll roll it back. Roll back complete. And again, if I select star from person, 3 rows, no 4th row. Okay, now the statement says rollback will act or commit will act till last commit or last rollback. What does that mean? Insert into person values. This first insert, after that I want to commit, and after these two insert, what we will do? We will do rollback. How this set of instructions, this whole set, let us see, this is our complete transaction to the database. First command is insert command, then I want to commit, then after two inserts I will roll back. What would be the result? First insert will be saved, run it, then commit it. We have committed, this means we have saved, means in any fresh session if I check, it will give me 4 rows. Again, if my original session says insert 2 more records, one row, 2 rows inserted. But now if I do roll back, how many instructions will be rolled back? Till last commit. Till last commit I have 1, 2 instructions, and this is commit, means my ID 4 will be as it is, only IDs 5 and ID 6 roll will be rolled back. I have inserted 2. If I select start from person in my same session, it will give me 6 rows. But if anyone, any new user comes and checks the person table in his own session, only 4, because this is the data committed till now. I don't want these 2 rows. If now I run the rollback, it will roll back all the instructions till last commit, means between commit and rollback, all those instructions will be rolled back. Let us roll back this. Rollback complete. Now here also only 4 rows will be displayed. This is how we can use and play with commit and rollback in case we are dealing with some critical transactions. Basically, it is very useful while dealing with banking transactions or any money transfer like thing, because unless whole transaction is complete, it should not be committed. Whenever any disturbance or any network issue occurs in between the transfer of money, we should roll back all the transactions, all the instructions given to the system till now. This is how commit and rollback plays very critical role in database, and we need to be careful while using insert, update and delete commands. This is all for today's session. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Please like, comment and share it. Subscribe button is in red, right below this video. Thank you. Stay blessed.